and I don't breastfeed the one-year-old, and, you know, I'm feeding him organic milk, and I feel bad about that. What do you recommend instead of milk for babies and also for toddlers? I mean, as far as, you know, they don't want to eat vegetables. They don't want to, you know, what do you recommend in anything in particular?
Well, of all the segments of our society, I would really suggest the key group that we need to really approach is our children. And as a matter of fact, I mean, that could be a life-changing experience early in life. And, you know, for the obvious reasons, it can last a long time. So I actually had a student who came and did her PhD with me at Cornell, who had, I think for 17 years as a mother, she had two children, had gone to her children's schools and actually had worked with very young children in those schools, kindergarten, first, second, third grade, and participated in getting these young children involved in eating the right kind of food, this kind of food basically, plant-based foods, and was getting really impressive results, she thought, educating these young children. And so then she came back to school mid-career after her two children had gone to high school, one was going to college at the time, and she decided to do a doctoral thesis, taking that experience and doing it more formally, got excellent results. In fact, the results that she got, what she did, she, in the fall, during the fall term, she got young children involved in preparing the food themselves. And then she brought in, she taught it on a sort of multi-ethnic sort of basis, bringing in different societies, different cuisines and stuff like this. Got a couple of my students from other countries to come in and talk about things. These kids really just lapped it up. I mean, they really did, they loved it. And she taught it in a sense of trying, you know, a sense of education, not just, you know, lecturing to them, you know, what to eat. And so she did that in the fall, and then kind of went away. In the springtime, she came back to test to see whether or not they had recalled. They recalled it in spades. It was amazing. Those children had gone to their mothers and actually convinced their mothers, let's get the family to eat this way. I mean, these little children were teaching their adults. And so the mothers, in turn, the local town where it was held, were going to the grocery store to get them to put some new kind of foods on the shelves. And so she got a national award, the number one award for most creative research in the United States from two major organizations. She had a lot of success. Then she went out, and now she's been out in the country, and she has taught this idea to more than personnel in more than 3,000 schools in the United States. And so it really is good. I mean, if we consider what she has done compared to what now is going on as far as the school lunch program is concerned, it's a monumental achievement that she's involved in. As far as on a more personal level, as far as children is concerned, of course, I'm not a pediatrician, so I can't speak directly to that, so I just have to rely on my pediatrician friends to tell me, and women who, mothers who have, you know, tried it themselves. And that is, human milk is the best there is. That's ideal. Obviously, breastfeeding is where it all starts. But then at the end of the weaning period, then going into the next phase, obviously, I feel kind of out of character a little bit talking about this because I didn't have, you know, I didn't have that kind of experience. But in any case, you know, getting onto the soft foods as quickly as possible and water. Water. You know, some people say juice, okay, some juice, but we've got to be a little bit careful about juice because juices are really loaded with sugar. It's not necessarily the best thing in the world to do. But just plain water for liquid, for fluids, and getting on to the same kind of foods that we use. And in my own family, thanks to my wife on this one here, we have five grandchildren. And so when I was getting enthusiastic about this, and she was getting enthusiastic about it at the same time, she had also access to two of her grandchildren who stayed with us at the time. And she really got with them. And throughout, our five grandchildren eat this way, our five grown children eat this way, and their spouses. So we're 100% in our family, essentially. Wow. And thanks to her, who really got the whole thing going.